Bismillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulullah, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala. In the name of Allah, the entirely merciful, the especially merciful, all praise is due to Allah, peace and blessings of Allah be upon our beloved, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and those who follow him rightly and correctly till the day of resurrection. Today, dear respected viewers, I want to bring to your attention an important issue. An issue related to al-riba, to usury, which is a major sin in Islam. Al-riba, as many of you might be aware, is of two kinds. Riba al-nasiyah, the usury of delay, and riba al-fadl, the usury of surplus. The first of these two kinds, riba al-nasiyah, is prohibited strictly by the verses of the Holy Quran and the prophetic Sunnah, and by the consensus of all Muslim scholars. There is no disagreement whatsoever on the prohibition of riba al-nasiyah, the usury of delay. As for riba al-fadl, the usury of surplus, there is a disagreement between the scholars because it is not mentioned in the Holy Quran. However, the Prophet, peace be upon him, stated in so many ahadith, so many authentic traditions, that this kind of usury is also prohibited. Of them is the narration in which the Prophet, peace be upon him, was narrated to have said, "Al-dhahabu bil-warq riban illa ha'un wa ha." Exchanging gold with silver is usury except hand to hand. The other narration, "La tabi'u al-dhahaba bil-dhahabi wal-fadda bil-fadda إلا يدا بيد سواء بسواء مثلا بمثل فمن زاد أو استزاد فقد أربى," which means don't sell gold with gold, silver with silver, except hand to hand on the spot, and except equal, in equal term, in equal weight, and the one who increase and who gives extra, then he has committed riba. So many of our sisters, the application of this appears when many of our sisters, for example, go to the gold dealer and they seek to exchange the old gold with the new gold. And usually they give the gold dealer the old gold and the dealer gives them back the new gold, but it is less in terms of weight. It is less in terms of weight. So if the woman gives the gold dealer, for example, 100 grams of old gold, the dealer gives her around, for example, 75 or 80 grams of new gold. And this is prohibited in Islam because it is part of riba al-fadl, the usury of surplus, and so applies to silver and some kinds, four kinds of food. So the way out to that was told to us by the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, when he appointed a governor to Khaybar, and the governor brought to the Prophet, peace be upon him, good dates. And the Prophet, peace be upon him, was surprised, and he asked the man, "Are all dates of Khaybar like this?" The man replied, "No, O Messenger of Allah, we buy the sa' of this kind," sa' is an old type of measurement, "with two sa' or for two sa's from the bad dates." The Prophet, peace be upon him, forbade the man, and he said to him, "لا تفعل," don't do so, "بيع الجمع بالدراهم," sell the bad dates for certain amount of dirhams, وَبْتَعْ بِالدَّرَاهِمِ جَنِيبًا, then you take the money and you buy the good dates, and you have now two separate financial transactions, and you avoided this kind of prohibition. So when a woman wants to exchange her old gold with the new, she has to take her money first, and then after that, with that money, she buys the new gold, and with that she is out of the area of prohibition, she is out of the area of prevention, and by that she is in the area of agreement. I ask the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us and to give us beneficial knowledge and to allow us to act upon such knowledge. إِنَّهُ وَلِيُّ ذَلِكَ وَالْقَادِرُ عَلَيْهِ. السَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ.